Behind me is one of the fastest and easiest to use 3D facial scanners for dentists on the market. The big question is it worth your money? Let's find out. Hey everyone, Dr. Ahmed Al-Hassani here from the Institute of Digital Dentistry. In this video, I will go over my experiences with the RAYFace 3D facial scanner by the company Ray. Firstly, what's a 3D facial scanner anyway? As the name suggests, these are scanners used to create a digital impression or 3D scan of a patient's entire face. Think of it like an intraoral scanner, except instead of scanning teeth and gums, you want to capture the patient's face and smile. This gives your lab a 3D model of the patient's face, which the lab can use to align with your intraoral scan and CBCT. This facial data is a huge advantage in any aesthetic case. Yes, we all take 2D photos, but this is next level. There will always be distortion with a 2D image when trying to reference it with a 3D intraoral scan. I personally have used the RAYFace for my cosmetic and full arch implant cases, but you can also use it for your orthodontic workflows. The 3D face scan helps give your lab all the data they need to match midlines, fill buccal corridors, and prevent occlusal cants, etc., better than any photo can. Facial scanners can also be used in maxillofacial surgery, but for me, I'm a general dentist. The focus in my practice is cosmetics. So how do you take a 3D face scan? Well, some of you may have heard of the Ballis app. This was an iPhone app that was very popular for this purpose. Unfortunately, last year, Ballis went belly up, and it is no longer available. This left a large void in the market, as many dentists enjoyed using that app. There are a few other iPhone apps out there, but the reality is they could be better. The best way to take a face scan is to invest in a 3D facial scanner. And there are two types, handheld or desktop. Now, without going into too many details, handheld facial scanners, as the name implies, are used and held in your hand and moved around the patient's face to literally take a scan of their face, much like an intraoral scanner. They tend to be cheaper than desktop scanners, but they also typically take a lot longer to carry out a face scan, and they can introduce stitching errors or scan errors if used incorrectly, just like intraoral scanners. The other type of face scanner is a desktop scanner, like the RAYFace here behind me. As the name implies, they must be used sitting on a desk, like a lab scanner. These devices tend to be much more expensive, and they can't be moved around easily in the clinic or between sites. So it's best to designate an area for them in the clinic, like we personally have done right here. So what's the advantage of a desktop scanner? They are incredibly fast and efficient and accurate. In particular with the RAYFace here, which was made purely for dental purposes, and it's not some dermatology product. The RAYFace can take a facial scan literally within a few seconds. Now, one of the main advantages of this is that unlike a handheld scanner, which can take 3 to 5 minutes to complete a scan, when using a desktop scanner like the RAYFace, the patient can actually smile naturally. This proves to be a huge advantage. So, who makes this scanner? It's a Korean company called Ray. They were established in 2004 and have been dedicated to making innovative x-ray imaging and digital dentistry solutions. Their 3D facial scanner is appropriately called RAYFace, and it works by using 6 high-resolution cameras and an inbuilt ring light, which you can see here, which turns white when it's in operation. This is all used to take a facial scan. These cameras operate simultaneously to capture the depth of the subject, helping create realistic 3D data. It literally takes a few seconds, and I will show you how it works later in this video. As a side note, the RAYFace just looks amazing. It is very aesthetic, modern looking, and we've had a lot of patients comment on how futuristic and high-tech it looks. One of my favorite things about the scanner is how easy it is to use. The software is great, it is intuitive, it's very simple. You simply turn on the face scanner using this button down here, and you open the software, create a patient file. The patient moves into position in front of the cameras, and then you simply take a face scan like it was a photo. Then the software will convert the photos from the 6 cameras into a 3D face scan. The one thing to know about desktop scanners is that they cannot move up or down. Your patients obviously have different heights. So you will want to have a chair that can move up or down, or in our case here in our clinic, we have used an adjustable height desk, which we found worked much better. So patients could stand up, smile, and did not have to hunch over. So is it any good? In short, yes, I really like this device and can confidently recommend it to my dental colleagues globally. The RAYFace is easily one of my favorite face scanners that I have used. It is fast, efficient, and completely fit for purpose. The software is excellent and works very well. It can be integrated with exocad directly and has its own cloud transfer service called Ray Teams if you want to send your scan to a lab. Of course, you can also manually export and send facial scans to anyone via email or personal cloud storage. On top of taking fast 3D facial scans, the RAYFace has a number of fantastic software additions, such as automatically detecting facial landmarks. Now, this works for the most part, but like many AI systems, it also gets it wrong some of the times. Additionally, if you upload an intraoral scan into the software, the RAYFace software is capable of automatically aligning the facial scans with the intraoral scans. Once again, it works for the most part, but it's not always 100%. Alternatively, you can also export these files separately and leave them for your lab to align them. On top of this, Ray has invested a tremendous amount into their software. They offer a wide range of free applications that lead to better facially driven treatment. This includes a built-in smile design software. This is a fully fledged smile design application that uses 3D data rather than 2D photographs. It does require the intraoral scan to be imported and aligned with the facial scan, however. After doing this, the 3D digital smile design can be designed for the patient. This smile design can then be exported and printed. Now, although it works for the most part, I would consider it to be quite advanced software for the average GDP. It definitely requires training to utilize it fully. There are other cool features in the RAYFace software, like the ability to combine CBCT data with your face scan and intraoral scan, all in the software. This is what the company calls the virtual avatar, and it opens up a range of different applications. For one, there are maxillofacial surgery and orthodontic uses, which show how the face scan will change in real time. There are also many other things you can do. For example, importing the face scans and intraoral scans into exocad to utilize the digital face bow, which can be very useful in restorative cases. Basically, the team at Ray are busy at work improving their software. They have advised me that they are working on a seamless 3D printing workflow to be used with their smile design software. The company is also planning smart aligner treatment modules that take into account root movements if CBCT data is used. Lastly, they are also working on fully automatic segmentation for the facial bones, jaws, sinuses, airways, individual teeth, and roots. This is very similar to what many people use Diagnocad for these days. Now, it's important to note that these additional modules are not quite released yet and will be likely available for purchase in the near future. Essentially, the software is great and you get some very cool apps free of charge. Currently, there's no subscription fees for the software, but just remember, some of these future software module releases, such as root segmentation, will be options to purchase in the future. So what are the downsides of the RAYFace? Well, like all new tech, it's the cost. The RAYFace costs around $20,000 USD. This is by no means the most expensive face scanner on the market, but it's not the cheapest either. You also need to keep in mind that the RAYFace does not come with any computer. Thus, you will also need to buy a laptop or desktop that is sufficiently powerful. Expect to spend around $2,000 on a decent enough computer. The good news is, as I mentioned prior, is that the software does not have any yearly fees, and there's no ongoing material costs or disposables. Essentially, if you can afford a facial scanner and you are in the market for one, the RAYFace is definitely a product I can recommend. It has been very useful in our practice. So that's enough talking. Let's finally see this thing in action. Okay, so here we have lovely Blanche to help us take a face scan, and the whole process is super simple and streamlined. So first things first, you start the RAYFace software. Once you start the RAYFace software, you are greeted by this screen. And just like most CAD CAM or scanner software, you have to create a patient file. You click this plus, and then you insert all the patient details, select a date of birth, and now the patient file is created. You click this camera icon here, and the LED turns white. This indicates that the RAYFace is now ready to take a face scan. And what you can see on the screen here in the software is six windows. And this is the six cameras that are used by the RAYFace to make this 3D face scan. So what you want to do is align the patient in these six windows. And in this case, Blanche is perfectly in the middle, as we can see in the middle box. But on the left and the right, she is a bit off the window. And so Blanche, if you can move forward a little bit, please, for me. Perfect. And now we can see that in the top windows, Blanche is in the perfect place. But in these bottom windows, you can see this little outline, this faint outline of a mouth. And so what we can do here is either move the patient up or down if we had a chair that moves up and down. Or in this case, we're going to move the adjustable desk up and down so that this outline matches her mouth outline. So I've moved the desk downwards, and you can see that Blanche in the middle is perfectly aligned. In the left and the right shots, she's perfectly aligned, and the mouth outline is just about in the right position. And so now that Blanche is in the correct positioning in these six windows, we are ready to take a face scan. And it's super simple. You ask your patient to look in their own eyes in this mirror. They shouldn't look at the camera, just looking in their own eyes, and please give it a very big smile on 3, 2, 1, big cheesy grin. That's it. And you click the camera button, and in literally 1 second, the RAYFace will take six simultaneous images and capture the facial scan. To turn these six simultaneous images into a 3D facial scan, you click this button, which shows this image icon turning into a 3D box. Once this is clicked, the RAYFace software will take some time to turn these six images into a face scan and present it to you. Now, as I mentioned prior, this can either be directly integrated with exocad or exported manually and transferred to your lab via any sort of cloud service or email. So it's as easy as that. Thanks for watching. You can read our full review on the RAYFace, including all the details about the software at instituteofdigitaldentistry.com. Thank you.